By fusing this two part with using the DNA ligase T4, next is the application of bacteriophage in the ligation. So very first we have to know about the DNA ligation process. So here the DNA ligation process is done into the two way. First is the ligation of blunt end. Blunt end means both strand of the DNA is cutted from the one point. So here the blunt end, as you are seeing in the figure, that first is the example, or we can say simplification of blunt end ligation process, and DNA ligase is covering that point and formulating the phosphodiesterase bond. Now in second, it is the ligation of sticky end. So here the sticky end, it means what? The DNA strand, both strand of the DNA having the two different point, and from that two different point we have to ligate, or we can say enzyme have to ligate at the two different site. So it is the sticky end ligation process. So now we are learn about the application of ligation of bacteriophage. So first application of bacteriophage, ligation of cohesive end. Cohesive end, it means sticky end. And second is the blunt end ligation. But in this, the rate is slower than cohesive end. So to improve the ligation rate, we are adding the monovalent cations and low concentration polyethylene glycols. And is also ligation of a synthetic linker or the adapter. Now next example of this DNA ligase enzyme is E. coli DNA ligase. So it is derived from the E. coli cell and required the NADA as a cofactor. Now it is the monomeric enzyme with having a molecular weight of 74 kilodalton, which catalyzed the formation of photodiesterase bond in the duplex DNA, which contain the cohesive end. So application of DNA, this ligase, it is in the cohesive end, or we can say it is used in the sticky end ligation process. This enzyme has the narrow substrate specificity and making it as a useful tool in a specific application. Because this enzyme having the limited specificity, so it is useful in a specific area. Application of this, so it ligate the cohesive end. It also cloning, it is also used in the cloning of full length of cDNA. It is complementary DNA which is produced by the RNA. Now TAQ DNA ligase, it required NAD as a cofactor. The gene encoding thermostable ligase have been identified from the several thermophilic bacteria. So this TAQ DNA ligase is obtained from the bacteria which are highly thermostable. This TAQ polymerase is also used in the PCR reaction, polymerase chain reaction, because it having the high stability against the temperature. Now several of these ligase have been cloned and expressed to the high level of E. coli. It is used in the detection of the mutation as thermostable DNA ligase retain their activity after higher temperature exposure. And it is also used in the DNA amplification reaction to detect the mutation. So this enzyme is used in the PCR. This enzyme is also used in the detection process of mutation. Now T4 RNA ligase. Till now we discuss about the DNA ligase. Now this T4 is the RNA ligase which clone or which ligasing the RNA strand in genetical engineering. So this enzyme catalyzes the phosphodiesterase bond formation of RNA molecule with the hydrolysis of the ATP to PPI. Now this, in this process, what is the role of particular RNA ligase is when The enzyme is catalyzing the phosphodiesterase bond formation. So when this phosphodiesterase bond is formed, so at that time enzyme is act as a catalyst. Now, due to this catalyst, when the hydrolysis process is occur between the ATP and this ATP convert into the PPI. ATP is a adenosine triphosphate and it is convert into the PPI, which is pyrophosphate. So at that time this enzyme is act as a catalyst. Now application of DNA ligase. So it is 5' tailing of the DNA with RNA. So here we are fusing the DNA and RNA primers. Next is radio labeling of the 3' end of RNA and DNA. So labeling in the radioactivity. Third one is production of the elongated molecules. Fourth is modification of internal nucleotide. Fifth is stimulation of T4 DNA ligase activity. That's it.